A very good morning to all of you. This is the lecture number 17 for the subject switchgear and protection. So today in this topic, let us discuss yesterday what we had concluded. In the yesterday topic, we had concluded in the previous lecture number 16, we had concluded regarding the protection of the lines. So after that, in today's topic, lecture number 17, we are going to discuss another important topic in power system, that is the switching surges. So before starting the topic of the switching surges, let us have an overview regarding the causes of over voltage surges. So we are going to discuss what are the different causes for the over voltage surges. Okay, but we have to concentrate our whole attention in this today's topic regarding the switching surges. So causes of over voltage is the most important or occurable cause for the over voltages is the lightning strokes. So lightning strokes generally occurs due to the electric discharge between the cloud to the earth. Okay, because clouds get charged during the thunderstorms, and the electric discharge which appears between the cloud and the earth is known as the lightning stroke. Okay, lightning strokes results in line insulation flashover or puncture. ठीक है, ये क्या करता है कि लाइन की इंसुलेशन में पंचर क्रिएट कर सकता है और फ्लैश ओवर इज क्रिएटेड. ठीक है, सो लाइटनिंग स्ट्रोक्स इज वन ऑफ द मेजर कॉज फॉर द ओवर वोल्टेजेस. सो इन द सेकंड कैटेगरी देयर आर द स्विचिंग ओवर वोल्टेजेस. सो स्विचिंग ओवर वोल्टेजेस आर जनरली अकर्ड ड्यू टू द ओपनिंग और क्लोजिंग ऑफ द कॉन्टेक्ट ऑफ द सर्किट ब्रेकर्स. ठीक है, और आइसोलेटर्स ऑफ ए लोडेड लाइन और ए अनलोडेड लाइन. सो ड्यूरिंग द स्विचिंग ऑपरेशन ऑफ द सर्किट ब्रेकर्स देयर इज अ सर्टन इंक्रीज इन द वोल्टेज लेवल फॉर अ वेरी शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन ऑफ टाइम, दैट इज नोन एज द सर्ज. सो ओवर वोल्टेजेस आर ऑल्सो अकर्ड ड्यू टू द स्विचिंग ऑपरेशन बिकॉज वेन एवर द contacts of the circuit breakers get open or closed arc is stuck between the contacts of the circuit breakers during opening or closing. So during that arcing time, there is a sudden increase in the voltage value. So that is the cause for the over voltages. The third topic will be the arcing ground. So arcing ground basically happens whenever the line to ground capacitance, capacitive charge or charging current get discharged through earth fault, that particular category will rise to the arcing grounds. So due to the arcing grounds, over voltages occurs. Okay, and the fourth condition is the condition case of the resonance. And the fourth condition is sudden changes in system condition. Let us suppose the load increases suddenly or fall off suddenly. So during that conditions, there are the cases for sudden changes in system conditions during the increase in load or decrease in load instantaneously. So due to that system changes, there may be the rise in the voltage values, and they may introduce high voltages in the power system. The fifth reason for the over voltages are basically the resonance. So resonance is basically occurs in an electric circuit at a particular frequency known as resonant frequency. So while during this resonance period, the impedance or admittance of the circuit elements cancel the effect of each other. Okay, or we can say that the input impedance to the circuit and output impedance to the circuit is almost equal to zero, and also the transfer function is also nearly approaches to unity. So due to the resonance, over voltages occurs in the power system. We are discussing just a short introduction regarding the various causes for the over voltages in the power system. So, but our main focus in today's topic is towards the switching surges. So last but not the least are the traveling waves concept. So these are the few main six reasons or most common reasons for the over voltages in the power system. There are more reasons, but in our syllabus or we have to discuss only these six reasons for the over voltages. So temporary wave that cause a disturbance and moves along the transmission line at a so why traveling waves are produced. The reason is that as we know that transmission line can be classified as short, medium and long transmission line. So for the analysis purpose of transmission line, we take the model as a T model or pi model for the analysis purpose, which we had already discussed in the previous semester, power system one. So for the finding the parameters, voltage regulation efficiency of a transmission line, the transmission line is thought to be composed of the various distributed parameters named as resistance, inductance and capacitance. So in a transmission line composed of various distributed parameters, so transmission lines have many sections of T or pi sections. So in each section there is gradual changes in the values of current and voltages. So due to that gradual changes in the value of current or voltages in each section of the transmission line, there are the concepts of traveling waves introduced in the transmission line. So transmission traveling waves has both the phenomena of forward and reversing direction. So that may cause the increase in the over voltages due to the traveling waves. So now we can conclude that we will discuss traveling waves in detail in the next lectures. So all these topics will be discussed in detail. So this is just a short duration, short introduction regarding the various causes for the over voltages. So the first thing is regarding the internal over voltages. So over voltages are of two categories named as internal over voltages and external over voltages. So external over voltages are basically due to the lightning strokes or a tree may be felt on the conductor, making the conductor to ground fault. These both are the most common external fault condition. And the next thing is regarding internal fault conditions. The internal faults are basically due to the resonance. The most common cause are the switching surges and traveling waves, or the most common causes of the internal over voltages. So what do you really understand by switching surges? So internal over voltages can rise up to 6 times as high as the normal value. So switching surges is a short duration transient voltage produced in the system due to a sudden opening or closing of a switch or circuit breaker, or due to an arcing at a fault in the system. So in this particular waveform, during this positive cycle, there is a voltage spike and transients. As a normal sinusoidal voltage look like this. So there is a sudden increase in the voltage or sudden spike in the voltage or sudden increase in amplitude of the voltage waveform. So these sudden increase or spikes in the voltage waveforms are known as transients, and these are due to the over voltage switching surges. switching surges are basically caused due to opening and closing of switch or circuit breaker, resulting in arcing or insulation failure in the power system, or flashover, which may lead to the outage that is highly undesirable. So what are the various protection schemes used for the switching surges? So various protection schemes used for the switching surges, for the external overvoltages, the lightning arrestor and surge absorber can be used. So the difference between lightning arrestor is, lightning arrestor divert the overvoltages or transients, whereas surge absorber absorb the steepness of the wavefront. ठीक है, दोनों में दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर्स, इन द कमिंग लेक्चर्स, व्हाट इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन द लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर एंड सर्ज अब्सॉर्बर. सो लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर इज बेसिकली व्हाट इट डज. सो लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर डाइवर्ट्स एंड सर्ज अब्सॉर्बर अब्सॉर्ब दिस और कंट्रोल्स द स्टीपनेस ऑफ द वेव फ्रंट. सो फॉर द इंटरनल, दीज आर द टू protective devices for external over voltages. For the internal over voltages, shunt reactors or series resistance circuit or shunt series impedance for the said purpose can be used. So thank you guys, today we will conclude with this.